Hi, my name is Oktay. Welcome to today's video about the chemical element nitrogen. This is a picture of liquid nitrogen. It has a boiling point of minus 196 degrees Celsius, which is 77 Kelvin. The atomic number is 7. The name comes from a French word nitrogène. Nitre means potassium nitrate, and the suffix gen means producing. Nitrogen was discovered in 1772 by Daniel Rutherford. This is a picture of the nucleosynthesis of the origin of the chemical elements. Nitrogen is here, member of the fifth main group in the periodic table, the nitrogen group. And it is produced in dying stars and in exploding massive stars. And there are three isotopes. The main isotope is nitrogen 14 with 99.6%. Then there's nitrogen 15 with 0.4%. And there are traces of the radioactive isotope 13, which is a half-life of 10 minutes. Nitrogen is an essential element for life. This is a picture of the abundance of the chemical elements in Earth's crust. You can see nitrogen is here. It makes about 19 parts per million in Earth's crust. It is not in the top 10 of the elements in Earth's crust, about the same as lithium. But in the atmosphere, it makes 78% by volume. This is the nucleosynthesis of the three nitrogen isotopes. First step is the triple alpha process. That's the reaction of helium-4 isotopes to beryllium-8, which merges with another helium-4 isotope. Then you get carbon-12 in Hoyle state. And this carbon can eventually enter the CNO cycle. In this chain of reactions, there are two bottleneck situations. One is called beryllium barrier. That's the fact that this isotope has just a half-life of 8 times 10 to the minus 17 seconds. So most of those isotopes just decay back. And this is the second bottleneck situation. That's the Hoyle state carbon. Again, most of the carbon-12 isotopes in the Hoyle state level decay back to helium-4. Only one in 2421 makes it to carbon-12 in ground state. Then you get this CNO cycle. Merger with another proton gives you nitrogen-13. Then you get carbon-13. Merger with another proton, you get 14 nitrogen and 15 oxygen, 15 nitrogen. And if this isotope 15 is hit by a proton, then you get a helium-4 isotope and back your carbon-12. That's how it is. These are three examples of nitrogen minerals. At the left, that's nitrobarite, that's barium nitrate from Hüttenberg in Austria. In the middle, that's nitrocalcite, which is calcium nitrate, tetrahydrate from Arizona, USA. And at the right, that's nitratine, is sodium nitrate from Antofagasta in Chile. This is how industrial nitrogen is produced by a fractional distillation of liquefied air. This is a factory from company Linde. And you make use of the fact that nitrogen has a lower boiling point of minus 196 degrees Celsius compared to oxygen with minus 183 degrees Celsius. The reason is oxygen molecule has a higher molecular mass. That's why it has a higher boiling point. These are the applications of nitrogen. It is used as a food preservative, for example, for pudding. In the European Union, it has the label E941. Then it is also used as protective gas, as a gaseous fire suppression for airbags and for aircraft tires. And nitrogen has the advantage, it reduces the expansion and contraction tires. Nitrogen is also used in the steel production. It gives a steel corrosion resistance. and better mechanical strength. This is a computer-controlled furnace for nitriding and carburizing steel, which is a method to harden the surface of steel. This is an example of the nitrogen cycle in nature. This example is from the mangrove forests. And in this process, bacteria play a very important role. The plants are not able to assimilate nitrogen from air, but the bacteria can. And that produces ammonium. Ammonium can be assimilated by plants. And you can see one decay product of the composition product processes is ammonia, which is released into air. This is one exception. That's a Venus flytrap. It's a carnivorous plant. It has a trigger mechanism that works in 1/10 of a second. It shuts down with 2 simulations. And then the Venus flytrap extracts the nitrogen by converting the amino acid glutamine into ammonia. These are very important group of compounds in nature. That's the amino acids. At the left, that's the simplest amino acid, that's glycine. There's just one kind of glycine. But all other 20 amino acids, there are two kinds of amino acids. You can see in the middle, that's L-alanine. This star symbol indicates a chirality center. That's a carbon that has a tetrahedron structure with 4 different groups. One group is hydrogen, one group is amino, one group is methyl, another group is carboxyl group. And in this case, you have this phenomena called chirality. L-alanine and D-alanine are mirror images of each other, but not identical. And the point is, all the peptides and proteins in nature are made of L-amino acids. The difference between proteins and peptides is just the size of the molecules. So the limit is about 50 amino acids. So more than 50 amino acids, you get proteins, and less than 50 amino acids, you get peptides. But the D amino acids are very important too, because they are the building blocks for bacteria. That's why yogurt is a very healthy food, because it has a few percent of these D amino acids. The human body contains 37 trillion cells, but 39 trillion microbial cells, which make 1-3% of the human body's mass. This is another nitrogen compound, a very important deoxyribonucleic acid, DNA. You can see it has 3 components. The phosphate deoxyribose backbone. And the third component are the nucleobases. There are 4 of them in 2 pairs. Adenine and thymine make a pair. And guanine and cytosine make another pair. And one important phenomenon which gives this double helix its structure is the intermolecular hydrogen bond. That's here in dotted lines. This works because the nitrogen atom has a free electron pair and the nitrogen-hydrogen bond has enough polarity. So you have a double helix structure, which means you have redundancy. So if there's a minor damage in one of the helices, then DNA repair enzymes can repair this damage by using the information from the other helix, which is intact. This intermolecular hydrogen bond can be opened, then you can add new nucleobases and a new backbone. And then in the end of this process, you get a replication, you get 2 DNA molecules out of 1. There are 4 nucleobases, but there are 21 amino acids. That's why you need a triplet of amino acid of nucleobases to code 1 amino acid. For example, the triplet GCA is the code for L-alanine. GCA is glucosamine, cytosine, adenine. This is the molecule hemoglobin. It has 2 compounds. That's The component with the spiral structure is the globin protein. Then there's this fat structure. That's the heme B porphyrin ring. This is the molecular formula. There's pyrrole rings. These are the pentagons with one nitrogen atom in the ring. In the center, there's an iron 2 ion, which is bound by a complex bond with the nitrogen atoms. And the oxygen molecule connects to the iron 2 ion. And that's how it is transported in the human body. This is the molecule ammonia, NH3. It is a colorless gas, very toxic. The angle is H, and H angle is 106.8 degrees. So the p-electron pair at the nitrogen atom occupies a bit more space than the binding electron pairs, so presses the bonds a bit together. Ammonia is a very important compound. The world production in 2021 was 235 million tons. Number one producer is China, with 32% of the production. Ammonia is 70% is used as fertilizer, but it is also used as a cleansing agent, fermentation processes, and as fuel. This is a Haber-Bosch process. This was the first industrial process developed in 1913 by Fritz Haber and Karl Bosch. It uses a high pressure of 200 bars, high temperature of 500 to 600 degrees Celsius. The first catalysts were osmium and uranium. The ammonia which is produced here, which is collected here, is can be withdrawn continuously. And the point is the heat and the nitrogen-hydrogen mixture that has not reacted is recycled. And this mixture of carbon monoxide and hydrogen is called zinc gas, synthesis gas. This is one of the steps to make ammonia. This is a picture of the high-pressure steel reactor, which is at the University Karlsruhe in Germany. It was built in 1921 by BASF, that's a big German corporation, Badische Anilin- Sodafabrik AG. And ammonia synthesis was one of the big inventions of the 20th century, and that's why the Nobel Prize in Chemistry in 1918 was given to Fritz Haber. There's another important compound, that's nitric acid, HNO3. Concentrated nitric acid is about 68% in a solution in water. It's over 86%, then you get fuming nitric acid. It is an important reagent for the nitration in organic chemistry, for example, in the synthesis of aniline. So nitration of benzene gives you nitrobenzene, and the reduction gives you aniline. The process to make nitric acid is the Ostwald process, invented by Wilhelm Ostwald in 1902. It uses a platinum catalyst, a high temperature of 600 to 800 degrees Celsius and high pressure. This is a chemical reaction, ammonia plus oxygen. You get nitric acid plus water. There's another very important compound, that's urea, CONH2O2. That's the structure. It is a white, odorless solid. Urea is the nitrogen metabolism product in the urine of mammals. So that's the way to for the organism to get rid of excess nitrogen. World production is 180 million tons a year. Urea can be used as a fertilizer because of its high nitrogen content of 47%. And you can make AdBlue. AdBlue is very important because in inner cities there's a problem with air pollution by nitrogen oxides. And AdBlue solution can solve this problem by reducing the nitrogen oxides. And urea is also used in medicine. At the left, that's the synthesis of Friedrich Wöhler in 1828. That was a big step in the history of organic chemistry. That was the first organic synthesis from inorganic compounds. That's the reaction of silver cyanide plus ammonium chloride, which gives you urea and silver chloride. This is the structure of polyurethane. It's a polymer of isocyanate and polyol. Isocyanate, that's the polyol. And this reaction works because you get this carbamate group. That's the carbamate group, NHCOO. It is stabilized by the mesomeric effect. That's why this reaction is possible. This is an important polymer. World production 2019 was 25 million tons. At the left, you can see one example of the uses of polyurethane. That's a foam chair. This is a nice picture of the dwarf planet Pluto. At the top, the structure is Halidrisi mountains, which are water ice mountains that are covered with dark material. The dark material could be solins. Solins are reaction products of hydrocarbons with nitrogen and UV light. At the bottom there, you can see the nitrogen ice planes on Sputnik Planitia. These are polygons with an average size of 33 kilometers. This is a nice picture of ammonium nitrate, NH4NO3 crystals, with traces of surface dissolution. This image is a microscope image. That was today's video about the chemistry of the element nitrogen. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.